We're in Little Langdale at the moment, just past the Three Shires pub. Just on my way to Cathedral Caves. So I'm not going in the mountains today. It's pretty much the shortest day of the year, and there's only a little bit of light left. So we'll do a low one today. Pretty interesting place, think you'll enjoy it. And yeah, there's a little bridge on the way called Slater's Bridge, and that again is quite a rare and very old bridge. So a couple of things to look at, should be good. Let's go. So just starting off down this path, and then we'll soon be out the caves. Right, so as you walk down the road, you come to this wall, and there's an innocuous little set of steps here. But the first place we're going to visit today is Slater Bridge. So that's just about a quarter of a mile from where I am now. There you go, that's how you know it's winter. Some red berries, just about a week or so off Christmas right now. It's windy. Right, that's what you face as you come off the road. It's a bit squelchy and a bit wet. But it's only a quarter of a mile. And let's have a look at that view over there. There we go, it's a little winter scene for us. Right, once you're through that gate, we just walk down the hill to Slater's Bridge. It's a very old bridge. It's got a very smooth surface, so there's been many a boot walked over that bridge. Little tumble down wall there. So just as I come down around the corner now, you can just see Slater's Bridge there. So we're going to get on top of that and have a look at it. It's the reason I've really come today is because it's dead quiet, and when I've been here in the summer, there's hundreds of people all over it. But nobody today, because obviously, well, it's 10 degrees, it's all right, it's Sunday, it's December, but it's about 10 degrees, so it's quite a nice day. So yeah, good to get in the lakes when it's a bit quieter, as long as you dress properly, it's all right. Slater's Bridge. Now this is very old. I'll pop in the description the age of it. Let's look at that. Been many a boot over here. Been maintained and patched up a few times, I think. But yeah, the water's crystal clear. I'll say it's winter. It's been raining pretty heavily. Look at that. That is warm. There you go, it's a good sturdy bridge though. I like it. So just a little bit further down this road here is the caves. You can see the slate there in the distance. It's just all a bit messy where it's been mined. Okay, so we're going through here. So then we come to this little gate. There's an option for, there's like a stile here as well. You can go through there if you want to. But I'm going to choose the gate today. Just turn left to go down here, so it's a little distance. And then we're going to turn right and head straight to the caves, and we can show you those. There's the valley just behind. So Langdale's over that area. I've been here before for a walk from Langdale. I just stumbled across this by accident actually. So going up this other side path here. Here we go, it's pretty sharp. The amount of moss on these rocks, I'll say they've been here for a long time. It's essentially the spoil from the mining. Some thick old moss there. As we're coming through, seeing a little bit of form of where the structures would have been. There's another little wall here. Must have been a shelter of some sort. Right, it's just next to the shelter. There's a little tiny inlet of a cave. It's been something down there. There's plenty of little holes to go investigating when you come down here. I'm not going too far in because it's probably a badger. Ooh. Ooh. That was a little detour, so, but I'm going now the way I'm supposed to go, down the road a little bit. I'm going further down the road and then round. I said the whole thing's only 2k, so it's a pretty short walk. Quite a few old trees been down here. There's high winds not so long ago, but they've been down about a year, I think. We're coming to this gate and we're just going to head up through that path there. Look at all that. Can you hear that? Slate, not a spoil.
There we go.
You can just see the first cave coming into sight there. We'll go in, I'll have to dig out the head torches. Just get the head torch out and then we can have a look through and see what's in the cave. Ooh, zombies. Let's have a look in the cave then, see what there is. Pretty dark actually. Let me just adjust my setting. The caves themselves look pretty solid. It's well mined out. I think, oh, here's the central pillar. So once you come to this large cave, that's the central pillar you can see in front. It's really getting quite dull today, but you can still see quite a bit. Wow. Let's have a little walk around and see what there is. It's pretty smooth. That's the central column. Wow, it's very impressive. And there's the main window. A few minutes. Just going to travel up a few feet and then we'll be at the cave from the top bit where we could see the window before. We're walking down here. This is one of the other entrances. Ooh, it's a little bit tight. And then I think we can see the window there that we saw earlier on. Full little nooks and crannies around here. Oh yes. So this is like a flat platform. I'll try and show you inside, but obviously it's a bit dark, so we'll see. Oh, it's a little bit treacherous to get over here, but I think it's going to be worth it. See, it's pretty dark, but they can see the cavernous effect on it. Show the roof around there. But that is massive. And it is straight off. So if you are around here, just be careful because that's the edge and then there's a massive drop. Cool. That is the top window and the bottom. Done. So let's go and explore a few of the other caves around here. There is a really long one which I want to show you. Need to get the head torch on for that one. Right, wee, got myself out. Great little walk this if you just want to do like a low level wander around. It's a really nice extra gem you can pick up that's not full fell walking. Right, now we're at the top. This is the other platform. Again, nobody here, so that's really why I brought you today. Because normally this is full of people in the summer. They've got a viewing platform here, and then there's one further up. So I'll have a look at the caverns from here. Oh, you can go right down. There's a lovely path, so we'll go down there and have a look at it. It's a little tiny building. There's a few weird little structures around here. I think this is probably just people making things. There's like a million cairns. You know, maybe it's a craft club or something like that. How to make a cairn. It's an important skill in life. Don't burn a lid. The other platform a bit higher up, and from here there's a little set of stone stairs, and we can just head down into the crater. Here we go. It's full of leaves today, a bit slippy. Well, this is more foresty than I thought it was going to be. It's a bit of a distance. This is a little adventure down the hill. There we go, pretty much down now. Down now. Right, oh look, there's a little tiny tunnel there. Full of water though. So that is Cathedral Cavern. That's pretty impressive. Right, so just climbing out now. There's the cavern below. There's quite a few of these felled trees knocking around the area, but haven't been sorted out yet. This path takes us to the top of the ridge and the top of the main mining activity around here. So we'll have a look at that. And it's pretty impressive, and it's a pretty big drop off. When I was here in the summer, I didn't really realise how close it was and what a sheer edge it was. So just gotta be careful. Most people don't come up this bit. So if you are doing, just be careful at the top, because there's a massive drop off.
Well, just turn to the left, and that's the view out over the valley. A lot of loose slate hanging around. Looks pretty cool, pretty bouldery.
Just getting to this top layer now, and there's quite a bit of moss. It's really mossy up here. That's some heavy moss
Must be pretty shady here all the time.
We did find Slater's Bridge, and we did find the caverns, which were pretty good. So we enjoyed those, and a pretty low walk. So if you are doing something in the day, got a couple of hours around the Lake District, don't want anything too strenuous, and that's a really good thing to go and have a look at. Right, so I'm off to the pub. You can come with me, so I'll start having to think about what you want to drink, and I'll see you in there. On the way down, you've got to cross the river again, and this bridge is a little bit less aesthetically pleasing than Slater's, but still does the job. Let's get over here, and then it's a straight field walk pretty much back to the car, and we're heading over to that area where the pub is. It didn't look open before, but we'll see how we get on, because if it's not, it's all right, we'll find another one. look, I think it says, oh actually yeah, sorry, I'll show you this. It says Ford next to it, which means you can actually go over here in your car, but it's probably only about a foot deep, so kind of depends what kind of car you got. But the idea is you come down there, that's the indicator at the side, so it's saying it's probably like 25 centimeters deep at the moment. And then if you have such a car, you'll end up back on this road and you can crack on with your journey. This is the road back up, there's a few sheep out, and once we've got up here, we've finished our grueling 2k walk. Oh, that pint's going to be good. When I was going down the road the first time and we turned off, that's the little turn off just ahead of me there. That's the Three Shires pub that we would have gone to, but it's shut, so it's okay. There's another one nearby. Some little bits of mistletoe hanging around. Nearly Christmas, next week in fact. So I've stopped in Ambleside on the way back. Here's the Royal Oak. Hello.